Hi, welcome back to the blog. It's Toby here. Here are some exercises I've been doing to help me get, stay fit and healthy and strong for rugby, but anyone can do them. We're lucky enough to have a bench press here, so I'm going to be doing some bench pressing for you guys to copy. But if you don't have a bench press at home, then you can just do some press-ups because they're roughly the same movement. Okay, make sure the bench is straight, because if it's not straight, you might have wonky angles when you're lifting it. If your bench has a foot wedge, just put your feet in like that and it'll help you. This bar here is an Olympic bar. It's 20 kilograms. Usually I'd be able to do heavier, but I'm just gonna use the light one for you guys to see. So make sure your arms are just a bit wider than your shoulders and at a comfortable position, and just roughly 90 degrees. Okay, so when you bring the bar down, bring it down to your, roughly just a bit above your chest, and then push it up with your arms. Okay, so when you're bench pressing, bring it down to your chest and then explode up. Then lock it, and then you lock your arms in position. Explode up, lock your arms in position, and then just repeat that. So when I do my heavy version of bench press, I do 5 sets of 30 kilograms. And you just slide it on like that, and then you get whatever clamps it on, and with our one you just lift this up, slide it on, and then you just clip it down like that, and then make a noise and then it's clipped in. When you're doing heavy weights, always remember to have someone kind of supporting it with you in case you can't lift it, so they can just carry it off so you don't injure your chest or anything. Okay. When you're doing bench press, I'd like you to be doing 5 sets of 10 reps. And reps are basically how many times you push it up and bring it down. So I'm just going to show you an example of doing that. And then take a short break. So straight after you've done the a set of bench press, you go straight on to do a dumbbell row. My weight's at 7 kilograms, but what is called is an antagonistic set, which is superset sometimes. But basically, it's doing the opposite movement, because the bench press, you're pushing up, and that's like the main movement, pushing up. With this, the main movement is pulling up. So you've got your leg back and you've got your knee forward like that. And then you put your hand on there and you grab the weight, move it to where you want to, and you just pull it up to about shoulder height, and then you bring it down. I'm gonna be doing 10 reps each side. So I'm gonna be doing one right hand, one left hand. Okay, now I've done that, swap it over to the other side and make it quick, because otherwise. So this is basically your break time right now. Okay, now take 30 seconds off and then go back to the bench press. So just pause the video and have a relax for about 30 seconds and then go straight back into it. So after you've done your weights, remember to put them away, because otherwise you'll hurt someone, because they'll trip over it and stuff like that. So now we're going to do a weighted back squat. But if you're not, you don't have like a light weight that you can just put on your back and squat with it, if you don't have that kind of thing, then just do some normal squats, just like that. And I'm gonna be doing a weighted squat. So I'm gonna be using an 11 kilogram weight, but just so you know how, like, the kind of technique, I'm just gonna be doing a little demonstration. So you've got like an imaginary bar here, and you're just gonna squat down and come up. Squat down and come up. But don't be squatting like that, because one, the weight's gonna roll off. Two, that's just, you're just bending your back. So remember, it always comes from the thighs. Squat down and then up. Okay, this is how you're gonna lift it up onto your back, because otherwise it's gonna hurt yourself or something. You're just gonna lift it up. And just like that, simple movement. Show you again. Pull up to your waist, push it up to here, push it up, just push it down to your back. So usually I'd be doing 5 sets, 10 reps, because this is an amazing exercise for doing sprinting, for working on your sprint pace. I'm just gonna do some squats now. And take a break. So after you've done your set, take 30 seconds off and then start on the other set. And if it's a bit too hard for you, then you can make it shorter by doing 3 sets instead. So I'm gonna be doing a dumbbell curl with 5 kilogram weight here. And a dumbbell curl is really hard, but it's really effective as well. So I'm just gonna give you a demonstration. So say if you've got like a thing like that on your bench, and just put your hand on it and then hold the weight, just bring it down to about there and lift it back up. So I want you to be doing 3 sets of 10 reps on this. So then you use your other hand, just bring it down, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and then the other hand, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this particular drill helps your biceps.
Toby, which way to the beach?
That way! This is an alternative to a back squat, it's called the gobbler squat, and you use a medicine ball instead of a barbell. So you lift it up like this, and then you're just gonna squat down. Okay, this next exercise is a really good rugby exercise. It's called shrugs, and I'll be using a 24 kilogram kettlebell, so that's heavier than that weight. And you really need a heavy weight for this exercise, because it's really good for explosive forwards who, say if someone had the ball and the forward was trying to rip it off him, is really good for ripping that ball off, like really just completely taking the ball off them. And so basically, you just lift it up like that, and all you do is lift your shoulders up. But it helps a lot. So I want you to be doing 5 sets of 10 reps on this one. now take a break and go back in. So for the shrugs, you can use a pot of paint for that. So you can just go like that with some paint. It won't be as effective, but it will still be useful. And same thing for the dumbbell curls. You can use a pot of paint and just go like that. Of course, keep the top on, because otherwise you can get really paint everywhere. So now we're going to be doing the kettlebell swing. And I'll be using 16 kilogram weight for this. And basically, all you do is you're going to bring it down and then up. Down and then up. Down and then up. Down and then up. And you keep on doing that and you can get it quite high. Some people can get it over their heads, but I can't do that. And you just do that for a bit and that gets you good muscles. So this is a full body functional exercise because it works your biceps, it works your core, it works your thighs, it works your shoulders. So it's really good. So for this one, I want you to do 3 sets of 20 reps. But if that's too much, you can maybe do 3 sets of 10 reps. And if you want even more, you could do 5 sets of 20 reps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Okay, that's you done. I'll take a 30 second rest again and then get back in. So for this one, we're outside. It's a nice day. We got some clouds over there, so hope it doesn't rain. But we're gonna be doing a slam ball. You have to do this one outside, because otherwise if you do it inside, you'll damage the floor and you don't want that. So then you'll be doing like 1,000 pounds of work to be done to your house when people can't actually come to your house. But yeah, lovely day, as I said. But we're gonna be doing a slam ball. This, it's a fully functional exercise, so it does a lot of your muscles and it does like your thighs, your biceps, it does a lot. But what we're gonna do is we're gonna lift it up, probably to our chest, lift it over our head, slam it down as hard as you can. Don't just like drop it like that, because that's, you wanna really slam it down. You're gonna do 3 sets of 10 reps with this one. Now I'll take a break and do that again. Now this one's really hard, so it's really good for you. Remember to keep your squat form. I don't think I did towards the end, but still try and keep your squat form. Okay, so we're gonna do some press ups. Sorry to the people who did press ups at the start because of the bench press, but you'll have to be doing it again and you're gonna be doing it for a much longer time. Sorry about that, but so we'll press up. Plank position kind of thing, not that kind of plank, upright, hands about shoulder width apart, just go down and up. Pretty easy, but you'll be having to do 3 sets to failure. It's gonna be pretty hard. Okay, let's go. Keep on going, remember this is all gonna come in handy. Okay, Okay, and once you're done, take a long time off and then go back in. Okay, now we're going to be doing so deadlift. So get the heaviest weight you have in your house and just do that, because the heaviest weight you can lift, because if you can't lift it, there's no point in doing it. But I've got two ways here. One I'm going to show you the technique with, and the other, that's where I'm going to actually do my deadlift. I can roughly do about 50 kilos deadlift, but I'm just going to show you this one and then do 40 kilograms there. Okay, so it's almost like a squat. You just come in, pick it up like that, bring it up, push your hips forward, and push it down. Okay, and keep your back straight, so it's like, if you're imagining you're lifting it, bring it up and then down. Easy as that. Just gentle squat down and bring it up. And again. And as an example, now I'm going to do it on the bigger weight. So we're only going to be doing two sets of 5 reps deadlift. But one of the strong men in the strongman competition called Hafvor Bjørnsen can deadlift 500 kilograms, which is a huge amount compared to what I'm lifting. 1. Try not to slam it down like I did just then. 2. Just do 2 more reps of those and you'll be fine. That's all for this video. Go and check out my other videos that I'm going to be putting up, which is other rugby based training that you can do even if you're not a rugby player yourself. But I've got one challenge for you to do. See if how many pull-ups you can do on a pull-up bar or just on a sturdy branch. And like, even if you do 1, that's fine. But let me know in the comments below how much you can do.